You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen,
Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen.
But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Wildcats.
I'm Brendan Snow.
I'm Gracie Ferder.
And happy Wednesday. Today is December 12th. What's for the lunch today?
For the lunch today is hot dogs, green beans, and applesauce. Hey Brendan, what's the joke of the day?
The joke of the day is, what do you get when you mix a Christmas tree with an iPad?
What?
A pineapple. What is the quote?
The quote is, the time is always right to do something right. Martin Luther King Jr. Brandon, what's the NBI topic of the week?
The NBI topic of the week is, instead of talking about someone, talk to them about something you like. What's the word of the day?
The word of the day is immure to enclose within walls. Hey Brendan, what's the anti-bullying?
The anti-bullying is, what if the kid you bullied at school grew up and turned out to be the only surgeon who could save your life? Gracie, what are some birthdays today?
Happy birthday to Katie Ellingson. What's the fun fact?
The fun fact is, penguins used to be 6 feet tall.
What is the weather like in Butte today?
Hey Gracie, what are the announcements?
Announcements are Thursday Hall of Fame at 1 o'clock and Friday WCC for first and second.
Okay. Wildcats, see you again tomorrow. Go Wildcats! Maybe it's cold outside.
I'm Kayleen, and today's high will be 34, and today's low will be 21, and there's a 100% chance of precipitation, so make sure you wear your hat, boots, and gloves. Goodbye.
Hey Wildcats, I'm Jesse Blackman, and today I'm here with
Mo Helm,
and we will be asking him a few questions. So, what is your favorite part of the holiday season?
Opening presents.
What do you want most for Christmas?
An iPhone 10.
What does being kind mean to you?
Help others when they're hurt.
What can people do to show others kindness?
Show them around the school.
What does Whittier Pride mean?
To be respectful, responsible, and productive.
What is your favorite book?
Diary of the Wicked Kid.
What is your favorite candy?
Chocolate.
What do you like to do outside of school?
Football.
What do you want to do when you get older?
NFL.
Why is it important to be respectful, responsible, and productive?
So then you don't get in trouble as much.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
I'm Chelsea Blackland, and today I'm here with
Bailey.
And we will be asking her a few questions. So, what is your favorite part of the holiday season?
Being with my friends and family.
What do you want most for Christmas?
I don't know.
What does being kind mean to you?
Respect.
What can people do to show others kindness?
Responsible.
What does Whittier Pride mean?
Respectful, responsible, and productive.
What is your favorite book?
Pete the Cat.
What is your favorite candy?
Lollipops.
What do you like to do outside of school?
Playing with my bearded dragon.
What do you want to do when you get older?
Work at a snake shelter.
Why is it important to be respectful, responsible, and productive?
Being kind.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, dear Wildcats. I'm Lexi Jost, and I'm here with
Peyton.
And we're about to ask you some questions. So what's your favorite part of the holiday season?
Getting to spend time with my family and friends.
What do you want most for Christmas?
Polly Pockets.
Nice. What does kind mean to you?
Not bullying.
What can other people do to show others kindness?
Be respectful and responsible and productive.
Nice. What does Whittier Pride mean?
To be nice.
Nice. What's your favorite book?
Pete the Cat.
What's your favorite candy?
Chocolate.
What do you like to do outside of school?
Play with my grandma's dogs.
Nice. What do you want to do when you get older?
Be a teacher.
Why is it important to be respectful, responsible, and productive?
Because if you don't, you're a bully.
Thank you.
Hello, Whittier Wildcats. I'm JC Cleveland, and today I'm going to be talking to you about where you're going to get dropped off in the morning. So you don't want to get dropped off at the front doors, because then you're probably going to roam the halls. So we want you to get dropped off at your assigned playground. Thank you.
Wildcats, I'm Cooper, and I'm the Wildcat Wizard. And today's fact is, in 1963, Kenya gained its independence against Britain. Thank you, and have a nice day.
Hey, Miss Hawbaker's class. So it's Clay here. Right now I'm missing Danny. I told you guys earlier Danny was hurt, and so he got surgery last week. So unfortunately he's not here with me today. I wanted to just catch you guys up on what we're doing here at Tech. So last time we saw you guys, we were about to play Rocky Mountain College, and we ended up beating them. So that was awesome. We won our last football game of the year. But I know you guys told me a couple places you wanted to see at Tech, but I'm going to start off. I'm going to go ahead and show you the library. Right now we got a lot of students studying hard because they're in finals week next week, and so I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the library, and you'll see everybody studying hard, and then I'm going to bring you around a couple different places. So unfortunately I don't know if I'll have Danny shove me into the pool because he's not with me today, but I'll do the best I can. So come along, let's go in. So guys, now we're in the library. You can see we have your coffee shop over here, and I'm going to bring you guys in, but I'm not going to say anything because it's really quiet in there, so I'll just show you around so you can see everybody studying.
Hi Clay. Hey.
Hey guys, so I'm up here in the mill building. I figured I'd show you guys around the mill because this is where a lot of students hang out and study. It also has one of the game rooms at Tech, so if students are tired of studying or they want to take a break between classes, they can come here and play some games. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys one of the game rooms that we have. So this is the mill game room, guys. So I'll go ahead and show you. We have a TV over here that you can play video games at, and then we have some dart boards, ping pong tables, shuffleboard. We have air hockey, pool tables. So we pretty much have it all. It's a place that kids like to hang out when they're done studying or when they just want to have a break between classes. Hey guys, so I'm up here at the Mineral Museum now, so I'm going to show you around here a little bit. As you can see, I have a skeleton friend behind me, a dinosaur dressed in a Santa hat. They've got all kinds of cool stuff up here, whether it's rocks or it's crystals or it's gold or silver or diamonds. They have it all up here. So I'm going to walk you guys around just a couple of the things that I've seen that I like, and then I'm going to bring you guys down to the pool. See ya. So this big vault right here is what they lock up at night, and they keep all the gold in it. So you can see they have a really big gold nugget right there. I think I'd like one of those for Christmas so I can get all the presents I want, right? Yep, there's a bunch of gold, and that looks like a normal rock, but it's got lots of gold in it. So now I'm gonna show you guys they have a fluorescent mineral display room, so I'm gonna bring you there now. So I turned on the black light in here so you can see they have fluorescent light, and they have all these rocks that glow in the dark because they have certain minerals inside of them that make them glow in the dark. Just kind of like nature's own flashlight or nightlight, these glow right in the dark. And lastly, here's a big geode. So basically, it looks like a big rock, normal from the outside, right? But when you crack it open, it's a big hollow geode, and it has all these big purple crystals in there. Pretty dang cool if you break one of these open. So like I said, guys, I was gonna take you to the pool, but like I said, unfortunately, I can't get Danny here, so I can't get shoved in. Maybe another time. So I'm gonna go ahead and walk you around. I'm sure it's probably pretty quiet. We have most of the people that come swim in the morning or the evening, so probably it's pretty quiet right now. All right, guys, so this is the pool. You see it's pretty big. It kind of has some weird tint on the outside of it, but here's the pool. It's a pretty big pool. I don't know how much I want to hop in just because I'm not a very good swimmer. I hope all you guys are better swimmers than me, but here it is. It's a pretty big pool. I bet you guys could probably beat me in a race down it. So guys, thanks for hanging out with me today. I'm showing you the locker room right now. We got the wood lockers behind us for some of the older players. And I just wanted to remind you guys that we're getting closer to Christmas, and next week we're gonna talk about caring and giving. And so I want you guys to think about some of the things that you guys think that caring and giving is, and maybe some examples that you guys have. As we know, it's getting closer to Christmas and you give out presents, but we got to think about the people that are less fortunate and that we give to them, and the food drive and the clothing drive. So I just want you guys to think about some ideas next week when we come for to talk about caring and giving, and hope you guys have a good week, and we'll see you next Tuesday. Thanks, guys.